So I just set up a new virtual machine, and it's pretty much vanilla. Need to determine the IP address so that I can log in. Which is 12233, so I'll open a shell. Password. Alright, so it's a vanilla web server. I need to open up the web port first, because else I won't be able to access it. I also made a note about that, because that you also need a PhD for that. Well, you don't need a PhD, but there's a new service for that, firewall command. Alright, so now I should be able to access the website, and I'll just 192.168.1.2.2.3.3, and that's not working, of course, obviously, nothing ever works. 12233, and I oh, and it's because the service isn't up, of course. System control start httpd. It's always a good idea to have the service running, because else you won't be able to access it anyways. So it is actually running. So about mod ASI Linux. So basically, a few things to know. Apache is a multi-threaded application. ASI Linux basically is a system-wide mandatory access control system. Basically, you can tell ASI Linux to label processes and files on the system in various ways, and one of the ways is to use a type transition rule, which basically says, which basically allows you to instruct ASI Linux to transition from a one context to another, but that's only available if the source process actually executes a file. And with multi-threaded applications, there's no file executed for the threads. So we need to basically find a way to change context without actually the need for running something. And there's a ASI Linux function that applications can use called setcon, which basically can change the context on processes basically on the fly. So mod ASI Linux uses that. So the mod ASI Linux site explains some of this stuff. But yeah, this is a site, so make a note of this. But it's pretty complicated, I guess, especially if you're not very familiar with ASI Linux. So this is useful if you want to basically have different threats in with different security contexts. So, and there's a few ways you can do that. Basically, you can do that based on host virtual hosts. So basically, if one client tries to connect to for example virtual host one, then that threat of that host gets a specified context, and if one tries to access virtual host two, then gets another context. And it can also be done based on authentication. So if you authenticate as Joe, you can basically get a threat with a special context for Joe, and if you log in as Jane, another context. So you can have different rules based on who authenticates, based on which virtual host is accessed, and you can also do that based on which IP is actually accessing the web application. But I'm just going to do it based on virtual hosts. And then with that information, you should probably be able to find out how to do it based on authentication or on the IP address accessing this site. It's all actually explained on this site. So the information is all there, but it's basically for Fedora, and this example is also for Fedora. So I'm going to try to make it more general and just basically tie the pieces together so that you can figure it out yourself. So basically you need to install the mod selinux package. Now in Fedora there's basically just an RPM which you can basically just yum install, and I'll just use the shell yum install mod selinux, and this installs a package with all the stuff required. But yeah, you don't have that package in other distributions, so you'll have to manually compile it. So I'll just show you some of the important files in there, and I'll also show you how you can basically get the source so that you can basically figure out how you can create the policy that is needed if you want to customize it. So it's installing, and there's basically only three important files in there: RPM, query list, mod selinux. Basically the this file here is basically just loading the mod selinux Apache module. So that's just a modules configuration file that just says okay, load the mod selinux module, and this is the module itself with the SO extension, and this is the configuration file. So here you can basically configure mod selinux, and this is an important file. And then there's other stuff included here, for example the license and the readme, but also there's a policy module enclosed with the Fedora policy. Now this policy module, you should probably install that, but you won't have it probably in your actually you might have it because the source might enclose it, so you should basically install it. So I'll just show you where you can basically get it. It's basically on a Fedora Koji, Fedora Koji. Where are you? And then you can look for mod selinux, and then you can basically download it. So I'll just download the source. So the source is this source package, is the one here above. Download it. Save file. Okay, and then you should, or you might actually be able to extract it. Hopefully. So in your downloads folder, in my downloads folder is the mod selinux here, and then you should be able to extract it. Maybe, I'm not sure if that works for you. And anyways, this has all these files, the source files. So extract here the tar.gzip file, and in here you have the source for the policy module. So you can use this stuff here to actually compile it. So let's have a look at what's in there. So this is the type enforcement source policy module, and basically it sets up a couple of process types that you can use for your configuration of mod selinux, and it also adds some support for mod selinux. For example, the web server domain needs to be able to set the current process, and there's also it also associates a type attributes to the web server process type, and it also has some conditional rule that says if MCS is available, then transition to the full MCS range, so that you can use MCS basically also to isolate web applications based on categories. or separate web applications based on categories. But I'm not going to go into using MCS for separation, because that's basically an extra feature. The main feature is type enforcement, which is basically used for integrity. Then you can use type enforcement to actually confine your applications. But anyway, so this module, you should probably just install it anyway. So I could basically do that. Well, it's already installed, but I can basically show you how you would go about that. So make dir mod selinux, and then cd mod selinux, and then nano mod selinux, and then with the type enforcement extension, and then basically just paste that in and save it. And the same for the interface file. You also need that, but you also need that. So you need to copy all this stuff over. It's a lot of stuff. Copy it over and create a mod nano mod selinux interface file and paste that in there, and then just install it or try to compile it. So basically I need yum install selinux policy devel for this to basically compile modules, and you should make sure that you have the development stuff as well if you want to basically compile like it's done in Fedora. So it's installing some stuff, it's also updating, because this is basically the plain system without updated stuff, so it's updating the policy as well in the meanwhile. Basically you need the devel package for the make command, and also for other devel files that you need. So you basically need this policy module to extend the web server domain, I guess. So it's installing. All right, so now we have it. So let's see if we can basically build these source policy, these two source policy files. So make f user share selinux devel make file, and then mod selinux pp policy package, and it's basically building it. So now you can basically install it. It's already installed in my system, but I'll install it again. Se module I, and then mod selinux I for install, mod selinux pp. So now the module is basically installed, and now you can basically use mod selinux from a selinux policy perspective, because you need to add some rules so that it's actually allowed to do the things that it does. Because basically what you do now is you're basically permitting Apache or the mod selinux Apache module to do some selinux administration, to basically run threads with specified contexts and stuff like that. So anyways, we installed the module and we have this working directory now, this mod selinux working directory, and it's basically compiled the policy package with the make command, and we installed it with the se module commands. Now it's in the system. Se module l for list will we'll confirm that. So it's installed. So now we basically have everything, the basics in place. So let's have a look at rpm query list mod selinux, the package that was installed, mod selinux, because we need to basically change the config a little bit. So here's the location of the mod as a Linux config. And if you don't have it, you can create it, put it in the conf period D directory, and just create the file in there. And it's everything is commented out so currently. So see, everything is commented out now. So the first directive is only needed if you're using MCS for separation. So in this case we're not using it, but if you want to use it, and I'm not going to explain what MCS security model, how that works and how you can use it, but if you want to use MCS, then you need to change this to and I'll just make a comment how you would do that. So you would change this to the full MCS range, which usually is this C0, C1, C1023, and that will give your web server process access to all the categories, so that it can basically delegate categories to threads. So you can have one thread with one category C1 and another thread with another category C2, and that will basically isolate, separate those two threads, so that one thread cannot match with another thread. But we're not using MCS now, we're just using type enforcement, so I'll comment it out, I'll just made a note about this. So there's different ways to tell mod as a Linux to change the context. You can basically do that based on authentication with simple mod file, and it's explained here. You can basically comment it out and enable it. So basically what it says here for the directory HTML, and then this configuration requires a valid user, so you need to use the HTTP password to add a user to the database, and then you have the zone, and here's the database file, that out user file, and then here's some, this is, yeah, that's it for that, I guess. No, not, you need this as well, so you can basically, I'm not sure what this remote address here is, but I guess you can also restrict by remote addresses, I'm not sure. And here's an SELinux map file, and that SELinux map file is explained in it on this website here, I guess, somewhere. Oh yeah, here, the mapping file. So you can basically create a map file and then create some mapping. So you say user foo has these categories, user var has these categories, user bus has these categories. And that's just for MCS based. And then you have here another one, anonymous with double underscores, and then it assigns this type with no categories. S0 means no categories. So this can this basically assigns this type to everyone that authenticates anonymously, or yeah, if that's allowed. And everyone else is assigned this type. So if it's not full var or bus, then the user will get assigned this type without categories. The thread. So yeah, you can use this, and then here's that directive that we see in here, where it says, okay, look here for the SELinux map file, and the contents is what you see on the website, so you can use that. And then there's some default values, I guess. Anyways, so here we have virtual host-based separation, and I'm going to explain this. So this example basically says, okay, if someone accesses the dog example com site, then create the thread with these categories, and the cat example site created with these categories, with this category C2 and C1. So that means that dog cannot affect cat, and cat cannot affect dog, because they're separated by categories with multi-categories security. But we're not going to use that, we're just going to use type enforcement. To basically, we are going to create two types, and then say, okay, if user accesses dog, then give it that type, and if user accesses cat, then give it another type. So I'm just going to set up, I'm just going to copy this stuff over. and then to set it up. So first we need to basically set this name virtual host, so for every IP address, and then we need to set document routes and stuff like that. And we're also going to add some other stuff. Because we want to be able to show you that, that's this directive, scriptalizer directive, with a CGI script, show you that it actually changed the process. We want to have a way to prove to you that it's actually working. So anyways, we're just going to set two directories, dog and cat, two document routes, cat and cat example, dog example, and we're not going to use MCS, so we're going to remove the categories here, but we're going to basically create two new types. So we're going to create a dog web app T type, and we're going to create a cat web app T type, and then we're basically going to create some scripts to show you that it's actually working. So this dog and this is cat, dog and cat. So that should basically make it work. Now save that. We need to set up those two directories. Make their dog, make their cat, and then make their cat CGI bin, and make their dog CGI bin. And then basically you need to add some file context specifications so that Apache can actually access it, and some other stuff. So basically we use the SEManage command, which is in this, which isn't installed. Yum install policy core utils Python. If you don't have the SEModule command installed, make sure it installs. Oh, it actually is installed. So okay, SEManage F context AT, and then HTTPD sys content T. This is basically the type for readable content by Apache. And then just say okay, label everything dog and everything below there with that type. And then just load that into the system. And we do the same for cat, and we do a few others. Cat. And that's just readable so that it can traverse the dog and cat directory, and if there's some HTML files in there, then it can read it. So now we're going to basically also do it for CGI bin, but we use a different type for CGIs so that Apache can actually execute it. Scripts exactly for cat CGI bin, and the same for dog dog. And then just basically this adds file context specifications to the list of system-wide file context specifications. We use restore_con to actually commit that. Restore_con recurse verbose, and well, let's just force it, and then dog. And then you can see that it's actually resetting to what we just specified. So it's basically just changing it to the types that we specified for those locations. And we need to do the same for cat. All right, so now let's basically just create two CGI scripts. So nano dog CGI bin, and then dog CGI, I guess. And then I thought I had remove that. So I'll just find that with Google. Shell CDI script. See if something pops up that I can use. It's very simple. So basically I only need a few of these here. So paste this in there and remove this stuff here and just add an echo and then ID Z, which basically the ID command returns with the Z option returns the security context of the current process. So I'll just copy this over so that we can do this for cat as well. Copy. And a tmod plus x, of course, because it's an executable file. Doc CGI. Oh. Doc CGI bin. And a big dog. Jesus Christ. Sorry for my language. And the same for cats. So nano cat, paste that in, save and exit, and tmod plus x. Now let's see if that works in the first place without. Oh, we can't actually do that, but we can't actually do that. So anyway, so we basically already set it up, but we need policy to actually make this stuff work. So here you have the mod as Linux policy modules, and it has an interface file less if, and here you have some stuff that basically is allowed. So this is sets up the default types for setting up a new domain, and it already adds a lot of permissions that you might not want. So I'm just going to make it reasonably simple, I guess. I'm just going to copy over some of this stuff and create our own modules. So nano, and I'll just add it here, dog te, and I'll declare a policy module dog 1.0.0, and I'll paste this stuff in here, paste it, and these rules, oops. So we're basically using some external identifiers that we need to require. So I'll just require those first. Then requires block basically allows you to import external stuff. So we're using an attribute called HTTPD server domains, and we're using a type of HTTPD T, and we're using a role system R, which you probably don't need to import, but I'll do it anyways. And that's basically it so far. So this basically sets up the types for that. And then cp dog te cat te. And let's have a look at the mod type enforcement file. And here, basically, it does some stuff that we also need to do. So we need to create some domain types. So we're going to just create some these new two types, which was a dog web app and cat web app. So this is dog and cat. And cat. Web app. Cat web app. Let's see if this build makes f user share selinux devel make file. It could be in a different location on your distribution. Doc pp cat pp. And we have a syntax error, unrecognized character nano, and that's right, we need to replace this type attribute cat web app t cat web app t cat web app t cat web app t. That should do that, and then do the same for dog dog t. So dog web app t dog web app t dog web app t dog web app t dog web app t. All right, so that's done. Let's try this again. We have attributes httpd server domains not declared. And that's right. Typo. And now it builds. So we need to install those two. Sudo our etc module dog pp cat pp. And this basically just sets up the types and some basics, but it doesn't actually allow these two types anything yet, so that'll make it interesting. So let's just send a force 0 and let's try to access to one of these web app, probably some configuration issues still. Let's just set up in my host system these host names so that I can actually use that. Nano etc host. So the IP address was 192.168.1.2.2.3.3. Then basically dog example com. That should probably be it. And then cat the same. Cat example com. That should, I hope, work. So let's just go to cat example com. Example com. And then basically CGI bin. And then cat CGI. And it's not found. So I'm going to restart the service because we made some changes, I guess. System control and this is the server. System control restart httpd. See if that fixes it. Try this again. URL not found. Cat example com. and let's have a look and see what less var log httpd access log says. An error log. Forbidden. Actually, it seems I have an issue also. Yeah, there's it. There it is. There's the issue. Okay, that's a waste of time. It happens. URL still not found. For Christ's sakes. example.com. Oh, I hate that when something not cooperating. This isn't stuff I do every day. Dog example.com, cat example.com, dog. Seems okay. That's stupid. CDI bin, so let's have a look. I'm going to just do a quick look at another virtual system because less etc httpd conf httpd.conf. Yeah, okay. Fuck this shit. This is going to take a while. Oh, Christ. Yeah, this these directory options, directory I probably need those nano etc hcpd conf httpd conf. Yeah, and that doesn't work, that doesn't directory, this is going to be fucked up. All allow override all. Require all granted. I'm not sure what this does. It's some Apache access control, and then I'll leave that up to you. You're the Apache experts. System control restart. HTTPD, of course, there's probably some typo in there. Yeah, something is not right. That's stop it already, god damn it. Why is this so problematic? So that's a syntax error. It's anos, I don't know what. Now it works. Okay, let's try this again. We're in permissive mode, by the way, in case you didn't notice. And still, it's not finding it. Man. All right. The funk. Yeah. That's stupid. That's weird. Okay, this is not good for you. IP address show. Yeah. So it has still has some stuff in memory. Funk. Oh my god. For Christ's sake. Okay, I'm going to have to change this stuff. Christ. So back to that config file. Where is it? Yeah, I've tested this before and I wanted to make it smooth, but I'm using the same host name, so now it's still in memory. That stupid ass host name. It's still in memory, so it thinks I'm actually looking for another site system. That's white one working. And there we have it. So now we have cat with the cat process, and if we go to dog, we have dog with the dog process. But this is in permissive mode, by the way. Oh, and there's an error there with dog. Misconfiguration for dog and not for cat. setcon raw dog web app t failed. Nano dog t. Jesus Christ, the funk is going on here. I don't understand. Out search M APC S Linux R TS recent. Cat web app works, but dog web app doesn't work. Not dog. This doesn't work. Christ. Yeah, whatever. Fuck. Give me a motherfucking break. It's a struggle. It's a struggle indeed. It's not very intuitive. So I'm looking for some bug. I don't see it. I don't see it. System control restart XPD. I don't see it at all. It's just the same as all as ever. It just looks the same. Okay, have a look at the dog policy once more. Dog web app D, dog web app D. Why, oh why, oh why, oh why? Well, I checked everything already a couple times. I just can't find the issue. Did I fail to install it? Might be. SE module I dog PP and all this. It's the only reason I can think of. Yeah, now it works. So I forgot to install it. So dog is dog and cat is cat. I'll be damned. That's weird. That's just so weird. So let's just add them both into a single module. Obviously, oh, I know what it is, I think. Yeah, shit. So both were named dog. The cat module was also called dog. Oh, every time I make mistakes. If it's not one mistake, it's another. Shit. So I was overriding. Anyway, so now you have dog and cat, but we're still in permissive mode. But then basically you can, now it works. And dog works as well. Fuck. Okay, so there's still issues. You need to basically also compile them again. Forgot that as well, because there's still, for Christ's sakes. So I'm probably confusing the heck out of you, and it's confusing for me as well, because I don't do this every day. I just took a couple of hours today to try and figure this shit out. So anyways, yeah, now it works. Knock on wood. Now it works, and now cat works as well. Okay, so finally. So, but anyways, now you have the issues that if you ever go in a forcing, then it won't will no longer work because they don't have the permissions yet. But now it's just up to you to just add the permission. So you can just just add permissions. You could, for example, there's so many examples that you can do, and it's pretty nice. You could, for example, just give a dog a different, the dog web root, a different type. And I can just basically show you that as well. I'll just show you that. Nano dog TE. So I could use what's called an Apache content template. Apache content template, and I'll call this dog, and I'll do the same for cat. Yeah, this is also pretty complicated. this content template basically creates types that you can use to label your stuff. So, history grab as he managed, so I can basically modify this stuff here. Modify and now use the dog content type. And do the same for this. And then just basically the same for cat. And then restore com to commit that. Dog and cat. And now you can see that each have different types. So if, for example, cat wants to access dog and dog wants to access cat, then that won't be allowed. Or you can actually prevent that access if needed in some weird circumstance. So let's see what Aussert says. I can talk for hours about this stuff though. Here basically what you is what basically what you got, and then you should look at the cat and then remove some of this stuff. This is no longer needed, but so basically what you need is the following, and I'll just add this, copy, and then add that to cat, cat TE, add that policy in here and remove some. This can be removed. This no longer applies because we changed the type. We need to require some other types in there. Binti. We need password faulty. We need property. And we need shell exactly. So this basically allows it to run that script. And then for the dog, the same. But different. I'll change this dog. And then add the types in there, which is Binti, which is password faulty, which is property, which is shell exactly. And then basically compile the two. And then install the two. Now let's just set enforce one. So we're enforcing get enforce, and let's try this again. And we have an internal server error, so we're overlooking something. SE module DB can be used to hide or to expose hidden denials. So there's probably some stuff that wasn't showing, and it should show now. So let's try that again. I'll search MAVCTS recent audit to allow. Oh shoot, this looks messy. Here we have, for example, cat. Let's just copy over some of this stuff. And then look at it in the policy. So let's paste this in here and look what we have and what we don't have. So binti file execute no trans, we have that, but we don't have this one here where cat web app tries to traverse the cat content tether, and it basically needs to do that to be able to get to the cat script file. So we can basically extend this rule here where it's allowed to search the script exec, the CGI binder, and extend that to also search the slash cat there, because you can't get to these slash cats slash CGI there if you can't traverse the slash cat there. And this is search, to search means to traverse. Now this should be allowed. Cat, yeah, this is allowed. It's already said, it also says that it's allowed. Then we have file IO control execute read open get attribute, this is also allowed. And then it wants to append log file, and this needs to be allowed. And syscript exact, this is probably old. And these are all allowed. So this is basically all. So I'll just copy this one over. Oh, and we need the HTTP log file type. HTTP log. It needs to log to the HTTP log. So I'll just paste it in there and I'll copy this over. And then dog, paste that in, make it dog. Dog needs to be able to append to the log as well, and then just httpd dog content t, and then also include that httpd log type here, httpd log t, and now we have our custom web app security policy based on virtual hosts. And you could do the same with authentication. So if the user authenticates as dog, then you go to dog web app. If the user authenticates as cat, then it goes to the cat web app. So you can use or virtual hosts or authentication. So let's just try this out. Are we in enforcing? Get enforce. Enforcing. See if it works now. Nope, it still doesn't work. Why doesn't it work? Okay, let's do this something else as a Linux error. Let's do something else. Out to Y. We have would be allowed. By active policy. Set enforce 0. Yeah, it takes some troubleshooting. And then try this again. And here we have it. Here we have it. TCP socket. Here we have some more stuff. So yeah, it requires testing. So let's go nano cat te and add this stuff in here. I'm not sure if it actually needs to be able to read this one, but for the TCP socket I guess that's required. This one, let's just comment this out for now and go to dog. And we have an unknown type, but I commented that out, didn't I? Oh no, I didn't. And install it as a module. But yeah, this is some stupid that is silently denied that write, because it's assumed that it's a leaked file descriptor, but obviously it isn't. Set enforce 1, get enforce, enforcing, let's try this again. And again, not working. This is so messed up. It's probably then the security file, I guess. So let's just comment that out, I guess, and add the security T type. Same for cat. I guess that's it, or can't security T can't think of much else. And we are enforcing. Yep. Let's see if this fixed it. Nope, it doesn't. So annoying. Set enforce 0. Oh. This is really, this is something that normally doesn't have to be this bad. But people basically Oh, right. Seems to be not as Linux related in the first place. Google, I guess. Give me a break. Check your permissions for test CGI. Make sure the user group are your own bits. Read access. And does it have read access? We know it's an SE Linux issue because it works in permissive mode. But not in enforcing mode. And there are no AVC denials. But I've seen a lot, but I haven't seen this yet. I'll search MAVCTS 1510 and interpret. So it's really this execute no trance that's messing it up. Out it to allow. Out to Y. Would be allowed. That is so friggin' weird. Get a sea bull. All crap. So this is a bug. And I probably know what it is. I know what it is. Because if you do, actually I'm not sure, but let's just see. Mount table. Maybe someone is really No, it's not that. Root is not mounted with no SU ID. For Christ's sakes. I'm missing some policy. Let's have a look at mod if. Christ's sakes. Yeah. This is it, I think. Weird though. Remove the execute node trans and make this get scripty. Get and then get web app. For some reason, you can't. Seems you can't run it in the current domain, and that might have to do with the type bound statement above. Probably. At least figured it out. Some of this stuff is really not for the faint-hearted. And now the whole situation changes. Now the whole scenario changes. Try it out. Oh, and this is in permissive mode. No. Don't ask me how this works. Get scripts. Don't ask me how that works. Oh, actually, you can ask me. This is actually doc script doing this. And that property as well. And that property as well is also the script, actually. But it at least it does work. Oh, it's actually clean now. It's weird how this works, but it works. Get and force. and see module B to undo this DB. It seems to work, so I'm not complaining, but it's weird that you can't actually run a CDI script without a domain transition, at least not if you're if you have the Apache content template used. So there's a lot of buts and ifs. So yeah, it's definitely not for the faint of heart. I'm gonna leave it at this because I can talk about this for days. And anything else, you should probably just try it out yourself.